A very warm welcome from RGT Creations. In today's special Rakhi lesson, we are going to learn how to create the Lumbar Rakhis for our Bhabis and for our sisters. This beautiful Lumbar Rakhi for our brothers. This Rakhi is for our kid brothers. This is a bracelet Rakhi for our brothers. And this is another beautiful Lumbar Rakhi. So let us quickly discuss what all is the material required to make all these beautiful Rakhis. To make all those beautiful Rakhis, let me first discuss what is the material required. So we need some pretty ribbons to secure our Rakhis. Then we need some beads. So you can take beads of your choice. So these are big beads. We need some small beads, some connectors like these, even smaller beads like these. So just take beads of various sizes. We'll need some jump rings. We'll need one bracelet. Ender. We need wires of two sizes, 4mm and 8mm. We need white glue. We need our quilling tool, some crystals to decorate our Rakhis. Then we need 2 to 3 strips of 5mm yellow color. Other than that, I have used 1cm yellow color. I have used 5mm strips of red, yellow, dark pink, light pink, a thinner strip of blue that is 3mm. And a thicker strip of blue, of dark blue, that is 5mm. We also need a plier and a scissors. So let us grab all these materials and let us get started. Now let us start making the first Rakhi. For the first Rakhi, I am taking yellow and red strips. First, let us take yellow strips. So what you do is attach two yellow strips together at the end. Like this. Now after you've attached two yellow strips, at the end of the yellow strip we will attach one strip of red, then attach another strip of red, at the end of it attach one strip of yellow. So it's basically two strips of yellow, two strips of red, one strip of yellow and one more strip of red. Like this. Then start making a tight coil. So we'll make a tight coil. Now very gently take it out and even it. So just press it and even it. You just attach the end using Fevicol or white glue. And then take this. We are going to create a dome shape. So very delicately put it. Once you've created your dome shape, just apply good Fevicol on top of this like we did for the base. So first we are going to put it inside like this so that it sticks properly, and once the inside has stuck properly, then we are going to do it on the outside. So I'll leave this to dry. So I have attached 3 strips of yellow and 3 strips of red. Let us make a tight coil quickly. Thank you. So I have just attached the end. Now put it here, and to secure it properly, just apply Fevicol or white glue, any kind, on top of it and let it dry, and put the same white glue on the base also. Yes. Now while this is drying up, let us make another one. I have made a same size because we will be learning how to make two types of Rakhi. One is normal and one is the Lumba. For the Lumba, we need to make the Latkan. For the Latkan, again, we are going to roll 3 strips of yellow and 3 strips of red together. Now let us make the second Rakhi. For the second Rakhi, I have taken a pink color strip. Just cut it into half. And first we are going to make a drop shape. So just leave it, not very big, not very small, this size. Just attach it and make a drop shape. So now take a darker shade of pink, cut the strip into half, and we are going to attach it. So just apply a little bit of white glue. Now in this way, we will make few petals. Approximately 8 of these petals we will make using half a strip. And then take another strip of pink, take a full strip of pink this time, and we are going to make a drop shape. Not very loose, I am going to make a tightish, just secure the end and make a drop shape. Like this. Now take a full strip of darker shade. Secure the end. So make two of these. Then I'm going to take a thicker strip. See, this strip is about 1 centimeter. So just I'm going to cut small fringes like this, and we are going to make a fringe flower for the center. So cut small fringes. So here I have taken that strip and I've cut thin fringes here for the whole strip. Now take the uncut edge, uncut side of the strip, and we are going to make a tight coil. So this fringe circle is going to be the center of the Rakhi, floral Rakhi that we are going to be making today. Now just secure the end, and then just open the fringes little bit. Remaining we'll open once we've attached the flowers. So we are going to have this in the center, the half strip drops that we made, we are going to attach that all around. So just take a base, and we are going to attach the petals all around it. You just let it dry. Once it has dried, see this way, I have attached these two parts over here. Now we'll be making two of them. One is the rakhi for the brother and one we'll be making for the bhabhi. So for the bhabhi rakhi, we are not going to attach both of them on the sides, but we'll attach both on the top like this. And we'll have one attaching. So let me just put a little more glue. So we need, because we are going to attach this to the lumba. Just make an eye shape so that we can attach it here. Like this. Now let me let both of them dry completely. Now we are going to learn how to make a small teddy bear rakhi for our kid brothers. For this, what I have done is I have taken 10 strips of blue and I have put them together just like we did for the first rakhi, and we are going to put glue or white glue on top of it and we are going to let it dry completely till the time we make the teddy bear for the top. So this is going to secure it as well as give it a gloss. So let me put this to dry. Now we are going to take any thin color strips that you have. So these are 2 mm strips that I'm taking to make the teddy bear. So for first, we are going to make the face of the teddy bear. So I have attached 2 strips of light blue color together to make the head of the teddy bear. So just secure your tight cord with white glue. So this is the head of my teddy bear. In the same way, I've taken 4 strips to make the body of it. Now we are going to make the ears of the teddy bear. So for the ears of the teddy bear, take 1 strip, make a tight coil up. And just make a semicircle like this. In the same way, I'll make another one. To make the hand of the teddy, let us take a strip. Don't loosen it too much. This way, I have created 2 for the hands and 2 for the feet of the teddy, like this. Isn't it cute? So let us first stick it with our white glue. Now let us dry it. Now let us assemble the rakhi. So for the bhaiya's rakhi, what we are going to do is just attach a little glue on both sides. I have made these coils, tight coils, using 1-1 strip. So I'm attaching them on both sides. And then after that, attach another 2 coils that have been made with half strip. Now this I have done because I want to attach the jump ring in them. So just attach this and let it dry. In the same way for the bhabhi's rakhi, what I'm going to be doing is, first we are going to attach 1-1 strip like this, and right on top just a single one of light. So this is going to be the hanging part with this coming below. While this is drying, let me show you how we can make a hanging of the lumba. But before we do that, for the blue rakhi also, see, this has dried up, this has dried up. So let us first stick the teddy bear on top of our blue base. You just apply a good coat of your white glue and let it dry completely. While these are drying up, I have some crystals. You can take crystals of your choice here. Take a toothpick and let us do a little bit of decoration work on them. Now we can use half cut pearls or we can use Swarovski like I'm doing. I prefer Swarovski, so I'll be using my Swarovski for this. So now we'll decorate it a little more. You can put crystals wherever you want. So let me just put few crystals on this and show you. In the same way, I'm going to do a little bit of decoration on the Barbie's Rocky. Matching you can do or you can do different, because Barbie's Rocky will make it in such a way that she can keep using it as a bracelet even in future. You can also use this Rocky to tie it to your sister, so this can be your sister Rocky as well. So we let them dry. For the teddy bear's eyes also, I'll be putting crystals. That's it. For this Rocky, right in the center, I'm putting a crystal. And in the Barbie's Rocky also, I will just show you how we will attach the jump rings to make it pretty. So I'm just putting two here. Now, let me show you how we can make a beautiful Loomba at the base. So let all of these dry up. Now I have made this beautiful Loomba attachment. Let me show you how we make this beautiful Loomba attachment, because we need it for two of the Rakis. We are going to use this. Now take a thin wire. Now this is a 0.8 mm wire. Okay, I have cut a size. In this, take any small bead which is going to be my base. So just tie a knot to secure the base. Like this. See, like this. After that, you can put beads of your choice. So I'm going to put a small bead of pink color. Light pink this is. And then I'm going to put a big bead. So here I'm putting a big bead, a white pearl that I have. And then we'll put some small beads. So these are very tiny beads. I'll be using multicolored beads here. You can of course use beads of your choice. Like this. Now hold this right from the center of this, just pass it so this part comes down. Now I have these connectors, so just put a connector. I want to use my beautiful red bead. I have another connector on top. After that, I'll be using these three silver beads. Isn't it pretty? In this way, I'm going to make a small loop out of it. Not a very big, a tiny loop out of it. Just twist it two times and then pass it through this loop to tighten it. Pull it and I'm going to just cut my extra wire. So since this is a very thin wire, you can either use a plier to cut it or you can use a good scissors to cut. So just cut your extra wire and press the wire there so that it doesn't hurt anybody. So in this way, you can make your Latkan Loomba for both your Rockies. Now, after you've made your Lakkan Lumba, I have attached two jump rings on this. So on top, I'm going to have my bracelet, and on the bottom is going to be this. So just pass the ring through the jump ring and your Lakkan for the Rakhi is done. See, let me show you. Now we are going to do this on this Rakhi. In this Rakhi, we will be putting the Lakkan. So take your jump ring, just open your jump ring, pass it through the press it. We can use our plier to press it well. Before I use my plier, just put the Lakkan, then just press it with your plier. So just secure it with your plier. So once you've secured it with your plier, just put it like this. See, isn't it looking nice? Now both my Lumba Lakkans are made. I have to put another jump ring on top of this to pass my bracelet through this. So take a jump ring and pass it through it. Just press it and turn it over. So both my Lumba Lakkans are done. I will now show you first how we are going to do this. Now for the brother, for the first Rakhi, this Rakhi, since this is for kids, take a beautiful ribbon and just attach your teddy bear in the center. So I'm going to just fold your ribbon, find out the center point, and then apply good amount of glue in the center and just stick your Rakhi here. So in this way we can make a simple Rakhi for the brothers. I've taken another pretty ribbon, just find the center point, and I'm going to attach this beautiful Rakhi that I have made here. Let both these Rakhis dry up. For the third Rakhi, this one, we are going to make a bracelet. So for the bracelet, we will need jump rings. For one bracelet, we need three jump rings and an end which secures the bracelet. So first and the foremost is pass your jump ring through this. Press it and just turn it in the same way. So jump ring packets are easily available at all craft stores because it is used a lot for all our jewelry making. So when we do all sorts of jewelry for quilling, jump rings are used a lot. So just secure this and turn it around. Now we are going to make a pretty bracelet. For the bracelets, you can take beads of your choice. Now take two pieces of thin wire. This is a 4mm wire that I have taken now. On one end, we are going to attach it to this jump ring. On the other end, we are going to attach it to this jump ring. So just tie and secure the jump ring on one end. Now once you've secured it, you can take beads of your choice. Here I'm taking these white beads for my Rakhi. You can take any beads of your choice. Like this. Now in this way, I have made both the ends. I'm just going to attach it to this particular Rakhi and show you. So my bracelet Rakhi for the boy is also ready. This bracelet Rakhi is also done. Now for the Bhabhi's Rakhi, see here I have taken this, this is an elastic thread, and I have just put my beads on through this. What I'm going to do is that I'm going to take the center point of this beads, this is the center point, and I'm going to just attach my jump ring through this at the center point, and then like this, just secure the end. So let me just secure the end. I'm going to just tie it so that the Bhabhi can just slide it through. So for this, if you want to make a slide through, you should take a stretchable thread. You can take a stretchable thread like this. So, or a stretchable elastic. So I've taken a stretchable elastic. Just like this. Isn't it pretty? So this is a set of one set of rakhis like this. The other set is like this. And let me show you the third set also. So in this way, I have also attached my beads to the third lumbar, to this second lumbar rakhi. How pretty the lumbar rakhis are looking. So do create your own lumbar rakhis and main rakhis, and do share with us.
Do like our video and subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to press the notification button so that you can be notified as soon as we put a new video or are live on our channel. Thanks for watching, and bye-bye.